Mr. Agarangsi, Thailand is experiencing a rapid development of the biogas industry. What are the key of this success?
Actually, Thailand has been helped by European countries a lot, especially Germany. GIZ has been there for 20, 30 years, and they start a very nice program back then. So we have developed new technology over there, technology that is suitable for the area. On top of that, the government is really pushing hard on promoting the renewable energy, all kinds of energy. And biogas in particular is already also very developed. And the government has been subsidized the investment, also promoting technology and research on many areas on that.
Can you describe in detail this new feed-in tariff?
Here's the new feed-in tariff, especially just announced this year at the beginning of 2015. They have more focus on municipal management, solid waste from communities. They can give you up to 15 to 16 cents per kilowatt hours of productions. And as well as the wastewater, you can get about 10, 11 cents per kilowatt hours. And then they also have a special tariff for energy crops, and that runs from also about 15 cents per kilowatt hour.
Can you give us some facts and figures about the future development of the biogas in Thailand?
Yes, Thailand has been working a lot on biogas. The wastewater, all of the wastewater in Thailand almost all has been equipped with biogas system. So right now they are shifting towards the energy crops, especially with this new feed-in tariff. So we expect a lot more development in 2015 and 2016, more on energy crops and waste management projects.
How many biogas plants, in your opinion?
I cannot say for sure, but the target of the government, they want to have about 3,000 megawatts. That's a lot of plants. Let's see how good they can do.
Is there any biogas association in your country?
Not yet. There's a work in progress to set up that, but there are many associations in terms of renewable energy industries association. They can also work in similar patterns.
Okay. I know that you are working also on Biomethane, and it's a success story. Can you tell us something more?
Yes, there's quite a few biomethane projects in Thailand. Most of them are for LPG substitution because Thailand is a big importer of LPG and the price is very high. So in general, what we do is we upgrade the biogas to biomethane and we have to carry that by either trucks or other kinds of transportation to a local community where you can have a local grid, or you can have a small compressed biomethane tank to substitute a cooking gas, which is to make a community being sustainable by themselves. And that's a very good story.
And do you think that biomethane could be also supported by the government in the future?
Yes, right now the government hasn't recognized this in supporting biomethane yet, but we are working very hard in terms of inform them of it could lead the country to a sustainable future, and they should be paying more attention on this.